Right. This obviously isn't Snowrunners, but I've watched that many live streams of Snowrunners from people who's got it early. Obviously new players. This is just a very quick basics on the Mudrunner series and Snowrunner of how to bloody drive. Right. First up, your gearbox. Everybody is driving in automatic. Yeah. Doesn't work. Okay. You can put it in all-wheel drive. Yeah. Which some of you are doing. Okay, yeah, it works, but you've got no throttle control really. So eventually you get stuck. And you can't put diff lock on when you've got automatic on. Put it in first, or low range, and you can put the diff lock on. And it also lets you use this power. Gradual. And if you just move the wheel left and right, you should get some side traction. He says. And it will. There you go. If you just put a little bit of power on, you can drive. The idea is to keep traction on the tyres, not do that. Yeah, you go very fast, but you'll damage your vehicle. And ultimately, you'll go slower. And if you just put a little bit of pressure on, away you go. Yeah. But this whole leaving it in automatic, as soon as you break the traction on them tyres, too high. Okay. So get it out of automatic, put it in low range, and away you go. Use the diff lock when you get stuck. The other thing that I've seen people doing is Spider-Man. Because they're getting stuck, which is where you just constantly doing this, pulling yourself along with the trees. Ah! You'll end up tipping yourself over, or getting stuck, or ripping out the small trees. So when you do eventually get stuck, you won't have any trees to pull yourself out. So again, low range. It's not for going down steep hills. It's to stop yourself getting stuck. And this is a really muddy track. At the moment, I'm in two-wheel drive. Yeah. And if I put it in automatic and just hit the power, all that'll happen is I'll dig a big hole in the back. Moving the wheels left and right won't do anything, because they're not driving. Now if I move the wheels left and right, I will get a bit of traction, but again, I'm just digging a big hole. Stick it in first, you can put your diff lock on. Just use a bit of power, and away you go. Start this up here, switch over to the truck. Yeah, because a lot of you are driving trucks. Exactly the same. You leave it in automatic, you've got no diff lock. You can't engage the diff lock. So if you watch the wheels, the one with the least traction, all the power will go to. See that spinning? And there's no drive to the other wheels. So you're just driving with two wheels instead of four. Four wheel drive mode. It's the same. So you decide to put the diff lock on, watch the front wheel. There you go, now I've got power. Oops, no, I haven't. Hang on. I'm doing the same thing. Right, so I'm in low gear. My diff lock's on. Absolutely no problem. Yeah. Bit in automatic. Okay, we're alright on the solid ground. As soon as I get on the wet ground, I'm just churning it all up. Right. Not the best, not the best example. There we go. We've dug it in. First little hill. So, four-wheel drive, we'll get a bit more traction. Watch when we put it in first. How much traction we've got now. Straight out. And you can put it into low range and high. Keep the diff lock on and you can get some speed up. But it's all about the throttle control. Right, I hope that helps. It'll help all the Mudrunner fans watching the new plays on Snowrunner, because they're going absolutely insane. Yeah, so, simple thing, take it out of automatic, put it into low, yeah, and that way you can then engage your diff lock. Your all-wheel drive. And if you haven't got them on, you're just going to dig a hole. Right, so I hope that makes the game a bit easier for you. And opens up a little bit more as far as controlled driving goes. Right, thanks for watching. Adios.